This is John Keston from Audio Cookbook, and I wanted to share with you a little bit about Hydramorph. This is a new morphing editor for the Hydrasynth from Ashen Sound Machines. And the main reason I made this was basically to help me sort of understand the instrument and also to just explore endless possibilities of sort of generative sound design with this instrument. And what I'd like to do today is just show you briefly how I use the tool, one of the ways I use the tool. There's lots of different ways it can be used, but I want to focus in on just kind of one example of how I might use it, rather than giving you a full-on tutorial of all the features at this stage. So what do I have? Well, basically I've set up a patch. It's called Mutato Morph, pretty silly name, but essentially it's got two things. It's got one oscillator that you can hear. This is the first one. And another oscillator. Now both of these oscillators are set up as wave scan oscillators. And then they're also set up with mutants, which are set up with the pulse width ASM mode. So what I'm going to be doing in this video is showing you the morphing properties as they apply to mutants. So I'm gonna morph a couple of the mutants and we're gonna hear how things happen. I've also got some macros set up for doing things like panning. So you can hear when I bring up oscillator one, for example, I'm gonna latch a note so we can hear that. And then oscillator two. So the panning is set up there. I might do some things with morphing the rate. We'll see how things go. All right, let's start though. As you can see in Hydramorph here, I have mutator one. I have all four mutators available here from this panel, so I can switch between which mutator that I want to adjust. And you'll notice that I have one and three are the ones that have these check boxes that are orange. When they're checked orange, that means they're going to be active in the morphing process. So you can morph all the way up to 366 parameters simultaneously using this tool. That doesn't necessarily always produce very good results. It's better to hone in on particular parameters and go that route. But let me just bring up, let's start with oscillator one. I'm going to turn the panning off for now. There's no effects. I have delay and reverb that I can bring in if I want to. And then let's just start morphing mutant one and see what happens. As you can see, the numbers are changing, the ratio, the depth, the dry wet. If I go into the custom edit, you'll see all the different warp points are changing. This is one of the crazy things about the PCM ACM mode, the pulse width PWM ACM mode, is that it has all these different warp points, and that can sound pretty crazy once those start to get manipulated in different ways. So one of the things that you may or may not know about the Hydrasynth is that the values often show from 0 to 128 with fractions in there. Well, technically the range is 0 to 8,191. So essentially they're changing here, but they're changing quite slowly. But if you look on the software, you'll see that they're changing in even finer degrees than is visible on the panel. But we can speed that up. Right now I have this morphing at actually the fastest possible rate, which is 5 milliseconds. But what's slowing it down is the interval is one. So we're, you know, it would take 5 milliseconds times 8,191 to span the entire range. So if I change up this interval, what I'm doing is I'm saying, instead of going one at a time through that 8,000 plus range, let's go two at a time or three at a time, etc. So let me turn up the volume and you'll hear how that changes things.
Thank you.
There you have it. And so you're going to hear a lot more changes that way because it's moving much more quickly. At this point, it's 137. So let's turn down. I'm going to go back to my macros and turn down oscillator 1 and turn up oscillator 2. Oscillator 2 is also being morphed, but the mutants for oscillator 2 are on mutant 3. You can see how those are changing. Once again, it's also in the PWASM mode, so I can have manipulate all these warp points as well. All right, let's bring in some other things that are possible here. So panning. And what I'll do is I'll set the macro up over here to actually manipulate the pan rate. That's going to be macro number 4. And you'll see, actually that's not 4, this is 4 right here. So you'll see pan rate starts to change. That's changing quite rapidly, of course. We'll slow things down here a little bit by reducing the interval. You'll also notice I'm manipulating the wave index of both oscillators, oscillator 1, oscillator 2, and then here's oscillator 1. I love doing this with the mutators because you just get some crazy sounds, especially if you start changing the pitch. I just hit the space bar to stop the morphing process and turn the volume down on the Hydrasynth. So this gives you perhaps hopefully an idea of how you might use Hydramorph. Obviously, there's a lot more that can be done here. A lot of things can be manipulated with the mixer, filters, both filters, all of the LFOs. And one thing that I should mention is that I've included a chromatic step editor for the LFO. What this allows you to do is change steps based on chromatic values. So in other words, if you were using the LFO in step mode and you were using this LFO to manipulate the pitch of an oscillator, you could set up pitches, up to 8 steps of pitches, using the step mode. And this would allow you to program those in so you wouldn't have to program the numbers. They go in increments of -5, so you'll see as I move here, we go to different increments all the way from -60 up to +60. That would be your range of chromatic steps. So those are some of the features. If you have any questions, please let me know. Thanks for watching.